नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, सो फाइनली SCMPE CA फाइनल मई 2023, आई एम रेडी विद माई सजेस्टेड. सॉरी फॉर बींग 10 डेज और 11 डेज लेट. टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट, आई हैड माई लेक्चर, सो देयर फॉर वॉज टाइड अप इन दैट. आई नीड टू बी कम्प्लीटिंग द पोर्शन ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स, सो दैट इज ऑलवेज माई फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी. बट देन एज आई गॉट टाइम टूडे, आई हैव ट्राइड टू डू माई बेस्ट. नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, कमिंग टू द पेपर एनालिसिस, द पेपर वॉज क्वाइट सिंपल. Most of the students who have done everything should not have found this paper very difficult. Sab kuch jo tha, almost we all have done. Okay, agar aap logon ne modules bhi achhe tarike se kiya tha, so I do not think so there would have been any problem as such. Just one complaint from the institute, one of the questions, the information was not very clear. Second, un logon ne transfer pricing ke upar kuch nahi pucha. Third, might be a add-on thing, and that was decision making. Un logon ko shayad achhe question wo puchne chahiye the. Un logon ne jo pucha bahut simple tha. Rest, almost every chapter was there. So, in this suggested answer, what I have done, I have written the question number. It is there from which chapter in your module that I have written over here. And in my suggested, that is there with me. The suggested answer is there. Okay. Now, just one small thing, a disclaimer. Wherever the suggestions, wherever the comments, wherever the analysis part come, everybody can have a different answer and it might be correct also. Okay. So, these are not hard and fast solutions that are there, especially for question number one, that is a case study question. Okay. So, that question, you might be having your own views. Whatever I have written, those are my views as such. Okay. So we'll start it off now. Suggested of the institute will be coming out after 3 to 4 months, but I thought whatever best I can for you all, I will try to be doing. Okay. Now, starting away with the question. Question number one is always a case study question. I say in class also ki na kabhi bhi question number one first question ke taur pe solve nahi karna chahiye, because you will have to be writing a lot and you cannot be sure that whatever you are writing is always correct, क्योंकि वो case study वाला question है. So such question should always be dealt towards the end only. So I will also try to speak about that question, but towards the end. Just one small thing, in case you want this suggested that I have prepared, please message us on our Telegram ID. Our Telegram ID in this case is @AJNext. Okay, @AJNext. Just a sec. Yeah, it's working now. So our Telegram ID is @AJNext. Okay, so please message us with your name, with your phone number and with your attempt, whether it is May 23 or November 23. Okay, and in that case you will be forwarded the question paper as well as the solution paper. That is one thing. Second, for all those students whose attempt is there in November 2023, just one small thing from my side. I have launched chapter wise, there are 11 chapters in SCMP, so therefore I have launched 11 courses, one for each chapter, only at 99 rupees, which you can access from our app also. Once you purchase, you can see them on the laptop also, or you can see them on the iOS app also. Okay, so you can download our app and any chapter you can be watching only at 99 rupees. The moment you will pay over there, automatically your course will start. There is no need to contact us or ask. All the notes are also there in that particular course only. Okay, the app description I will put in the YouTube video. Okay, now we all will start. Listen, question number one I will try to discuss towards the end. It's no point in discussing that thing first. The video becomes very boring. So I'll start away with question number two. Now question number two that was there was on target costing. Target costing in this case is quite a manageable question. In fact, same question was there in our regular course also and in our crash course book also. Okay, so it was given to you that there is one company that is making the plastic bottles. The full cost of that thing is 400 rupees. They want a markup of 20% on selling price, so therefore 20% is 1/5 of selling price, 1/4 of cost. So 400 plus 1/4, that is 100. So current selling price in this case was 500 rupees. Okay, now they sell two bottles at a time, that they are calling as one set over here. Further, some features and all are given to you, and we produce and sell 95,000 sets per annum. Okay, that is whatever we all do. Our current stock, our current cost structure was over here. Material, we should have used this much, we all use this much. This was our actual cost. Same thing for direct labor also. Okay, we should have used these many hours, workers work for more number of hours, this was the actual cost of labor. To set up the machines, it should have taken 10,000 hours, it actually took 10,000 hours only, this was our actual cost. And for assembling the things, okay, it should have taken 60,000 hours, it actually took the same thing. And 95 lakh rupees was the actual cost. If you add up all these particular things, no, that will work out to some amount. If you divide that figure by 95,000 bottles, it will exactly come to 400, okay. That was the current structure. And further, those guys are saying that it has been revealed that actual and budgeted operating levels are same. So therefore, in actual, you produced how much? 95,000. You had thought also that you will be producing how much? 95,000. Okay. So therefore, this budget and this actual data is directly comparable. Now, what these guys are told, another company has launched a similar set of bottles at aggressive price of 460. Our selling price was how much? Rupees 500. So therefore, they have launched at 460. If I reduce my prices by 460, sir, if I reduce my price from 500 to 460, automatically my profit figure will also be falling down by 40 rupees. So therefore, then what to do? Then in that case, these guys have called some meeting, and what these guys have decided in the meeting is something like this. And that thing is that we will do some alteration change, we will add some strap up and so on over here, that will cost us extra rupees 10 per unit. And we have decided to reduce the selling price by 50, okay, to maintain the same amount of sales volume. And we want same amount of profit also. So therefore, try to be thinking, our current selling price was how much, beta? 500. We want to be reducing in this case our selling price by 50. Okay. So therefore, in this case, new cost in this case is supposed to be, sorry, new selling price will be 450. I want the same amount of profit, that is 100. So therefore, this particular figure is going to be 350. So 350 is supposed to be your new cost, but out of 350, 10 rupees extra we will be incurring because of this particular strap over here. So therefore, if you manage now to produce the bottles at 340, then in that case your job should be done over here. Okay. So earlier my cost was 400, now I want to reduce it to 340. So therefore, I want to be reducing my cost by 60. Okay. Now calculate the present selling price that we all did, that was 500 rupees. Also calculate the markup price on the full cost per unit. So markup price, also calculate the markup percentage. So on full cost, I guess markup percentage will be 25%, no, on full cost. Okay, further. Identify the non-value added activities in the production process. Now, non-value added activities are those kind of activities which are not valued by the external customer. So there are four costs that are given. Machine setup is always going to be non-value added. Jab bhi aap log koi bhi product vagera wo khareedte ho, aap log ye thodi sochte ho ki yaar ye company ne ye wala product koi machine ke andar wo banaya rahega, us machine ko setup karne ke liye kitna time wo laga rahega. So therefore, you don't think those particular things. Okay. So therefore, this is supposed to be non-value added activity. Okay, this was in this case your part first, then part second, part third. Calculate the new target cost per set and the new revised cost per set after the implementation of the above decision. So I think I have told you all the answer. New target cost in this case is going to be 340. Okay, so after the implementation of the above decisions. Okay, further, calculate the amount of the reduction in the cost that is required to achieve the new cost target. So therefore, earlier cost was 400, now cost has to be reducing to 340. So therefore, reduce the cost by 60 rupees. Recommend the strategy that the company should adopt to achieve the target's cost structure. So therefore, if you want to tell how to reduce this cost of rupees 60, so two suggestions. We were inefficient in usage of material, so try to save the cost in this case by using materials properly. Now these guys had told one thing, that no difference in the rate of the material purchases and no difference in the rate per hour. So any difference that is there between the budgeted cost of material and labor is only due to the quantity difference of material and hours of labor. So use them efficiently. How to be using them? 1,90,000 is a cost for 31,920. If we were efficient, we would have used how much? 28,000. So cross multiply, that will give you the new cost. 1,90,000 minus that particular new cost divided by 95,000 units. Now that I've printed in the suggested over here. So therefore, in question number 2A, I will just come over here. In question number 2A, if I'm going to be doing that, my material cost will reduce by 24.96. Okay, mark this figure, those people whose attempt was May 2023. Same thing for labor, 57 lakh rupees is the cost for these many hours. If it was these many hours, what would have been the cost? 57 lakhs minus that particular cost divided by 95,000. Once you all do that particular thing, then in that case, you will arrive at whatever will be the savings. Okay. So those savings will be working out to this much over here. That is 6.10. So total savings that we all have got is 30.67 till now, only by using materials and labor in an efficient manner. But we wanted to reduce the cost by how much, beta? 60 rupees. So then what is to be done? Try to be giving all other suggestions now. All other suggestions will obviously be pertaining in this case to all other things. All other things means, see, machine setup, you should have taken 10,000 hours. You were taking 10,000 hours, so that's not a problem. Mechanical assembly in this case, you should have taken 60,000 hours. You have taken that. So therefore, even that particular thing is not a problem. Okay. So then, now what is to be done? Now you can try to be saying company can use value analysis and value engineering to try to reduce the cost further. Try to think, can machine setup hours be reduced? Because if you try to reduce these particular hours, then the value of the product does not fall because this is a non-value added activity. Okay. So these are the suggestions that you can be doing. But whenever you're giving these suggestions, have a disclaimer. Company should try to be ensuring that anything that results in cost reduction should not try to reduce the value of the product. That thing is super important. Because if that particular thing starts to be happening, automatically in that case, the value of your product will be falling. That is not good. So value analysis and value engineering always says this thing, that even if you in this case try to reduce your cost, please ensure that the product quality is not hampered. Okay. Try to be thinking, can you use the fewer parts? Can the design become more simplified? These are all the ways to try to reduce the material cost, the labor cost, the assembly cost, up and so on. Okay. That is whatever was there in this particular question. Okay. Part number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Complete answer I have over here. Okay. Now this was your question number 2A. Then in that case, question number 2B over here. Question number 2B was something like this. That we are a manufacturing company called as S Limited. We try to purchase the semiconductors from somewhere. Okay, whenever we purchase the semiconductors, we purchase them from XYZ at an expensive price of 564. Apart from that, we purchase from RIM at 564, we purchase from XYZ at 516. So obviously this particular thing is cheaper. So therefore our needs in this case are 10 lakh semiconductors. Out of that, 80% in this case is only purchased. 80% of that is only purchased from XYZ. Why? Because it is cheaper. Okay. Now this company, no, RIM, this is one of our suppliers. Out of 10 lakhs, we only purchase 2 lakh units from them. And from XYZ, we purchase the remaining 8 lakhs because it is cheaper. Now, the managing director or somebody like that, the vice president of sales, Ms. Gina or something, she says that she will reduce the price from 564 in this case to 540 rupees per unit. But provided you have a long-term contract with us and you start to be purchasing 8 lakh units. Now you are thinking whether this offer is good or not. Now till now, if I try to be thinking, even if 564 gets reduced to 540, no, still 516 is going to be far cheaper. So therefore it is not an attractive offer. But Gina says one other thing, that my quality is far, far, far better than the quality in this particular case of the product that is offered by XYZ Limited. Okay. So therefore she says you should factor that particular cost also. Okay. Now, one thing that was vague in this question, to assess the effect on the cost of the two semiconductors, the following data were collected for supplier related activities and suppliers. Now, see, this activity cost, these guys have given to you. So inspecting semiconductors, 57,60,000. Then reworking of the products due to the failed semiconductor. See, semiconductors is one of the components that we all purchase from these suppliers. Okay. So there is one activity cost that is doing this much, inspecting the semiconductors, sampling only. Our people must be inspecting whatever the semiconductors we get, say on a sample basis, means we don't try to inspect all, we inspect few of them. Then if some of them are faulty, we might be reworking on them. And lastly, in this case, the warranty cost due to failed semiconductors, that is this much amount of cost. Okay. Now, purchase price per unit, 564, that was there on the last page also. 516 is over here, so therefore that particular data is also there. Number of semiconductors, how does 2 lakh and 8 lakh come, that we all know also. Sampling hours, 40 and 1960, I guess that will become cost driver for this. Then reworking hours, 90 and 1410, that will become cost driver for this. 400 and 7600, that will become cost driver for this. Okay. Now, once you all do that, evaluate the cost per unit for each supplier, taking into consideration the cost of the supplier related activities and using the current prices and sales volume. Okay. Further, advise whether the purchase manager of S Limited should accept or reject the contractual offer made by RI. So, in this case, see, 564 will not be the price because we have been offered a price of how much, beta? 540. 516 is still cheaper than 540. But if you all start to realize, there are these costs also. And these costs are driven by these cost drivers here. So therefore, try to include these costs also to try to be finding out the total cost. That is whatever I have done in the suggested over here. See what I did. First overheads is inspecting. Its cost driver is sampling hours. So try to divide this particular thing among your cost objects in the ratio of sampling hours. Okay, that is one thing that I did. Same thing for rework, same thing for warranty work also. This will be the total overheads divided by the number of units. This will give you the overheads per unit. So do not only include material cost, include these costs also. So add up the new material cost under the offer. That will not be 564, that will be 540. Plus, I guess this particular thing is 516. So therefore, if you consider this, RIM might be more expensive to buy, but when you consider the overhead cost, it actually becomes cheaper. Here it is 575. Over there, that particular number is 681. So therefore, it is advisable in this case to accept that particular offer. Okay, that thing is this part. Okay, this is question number 2B, first part. The second part, what was, you will read over here. Suppose that S Limited loses 240 lakh rupees in sales per annum because of the reputation effect of the defective units attributable to the failed semiconductors. Okay, so those guys are saying due to the failed semiconductors, no, we lose this much amount of sales. What these guys are saying now, select one of the drivers already listed and assign the cost of the lost sales to each supplier. Okay, calculate the change per unit cost in each supplier. Assume the situation before RIM, except the offers exist. Okay, those guys are saying that apart from the three costs that are given, there is one other cost also, that is opportunity cost. Now, because the semiconductors ka quality is bad, tum log itne rupees ka sales lose kar dete ho, aap log isko bhi yahan par assign kar do to the suppliers. Chalo, theek hai. Now, mere khyal se now, what these guys should have done over here, yahan pe na, उन लोगों ने क्या लिखा है, सिलेक्ट वन ऑफ द ड्राइवर्स ऑलरेडी लिस्टेड टू असाइन कॉस्ट ऑफ लॉस सेल्स. ये जो 240 लाख एंड एक्चुअली दिस इज सेल्स अमाउंट आई शुड बी एबल टू अराइव एट, आई शुड बी एबल टू अराइव एट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस द कॉस्ट ऑफ दिस. Now, if you can arrive at the cost of this note, then I don't think so it would have been a problem. Lekin shayad wo wala jo cost hai na, is question ke andar calculate nahi ho sakta. To maine solution ke andar kya kiya na, 240 lakhs also I have divided. Now, my problem was that 240 lakh rupees, no, I divide that particular thing in what ratio? I've divided that particular thing in the ratio of warranty hours. Okay, I've divided that particular thing in the ratio of warranty hours. Now, my logic of warranty hours was very simple. See, I had choice of these particular three things. In this case, I thought like that if suppose we sell a product to a customer, it has a semiconductor, that thing becomes faulty, then customer will be coming to us, we will try to repair it. Okay, now this brings us bad will, not goodwill, bad will. Okay, so therefore, I think the warranty hours wala thing will be making more amount of sense. Once you all do that, that will start to give you the total overheads again. So this is one extra cost that will start to be going. Divide that thing by number of units, that will give you the overheads per unit as such. Add up the direct material cost. Now this I am taking the before wala because those guys have told that. Okay, that will start to give you the total cost. You can compare it with the cost under part one. This will be the change in cost. Okay, now this is one thing. Although I still try to be thinking, see, this is amount of sales lost. there should be some way to be finding out contribution lost over here, but I could not find that particular thing. How do I try to be finding the contribution lost in this particular question? Because I cannot be computing the selling price up and so on in this question here. So it was very difficult for me. So I have assigned this particular sales only over here to both the suppliers. Okay. So this was in this case your question number two. Then question number three was on a chapter called as performance evaluation and management. Okay. There is one owner. This question, like question number three, is always of 20 marks. You must be aware of that. So in this question, there is one gentleman called as Mr. Chetan. Mr. Chetan, he owns a fast food restaurant. Has expanded to more than these many outlets, 90% of which are franchised. Now, franchisee business usually works like this. You lend your brand name to somebody else. Those guys will be running the business. They will be investing. Then whatever revenue those guys will be earning, no, part of that revenue will be coming back to you as royalty or commission income. Okay. That is how most of the franchisee businesses work. But two of the firms operated outlets. Now, these are operated by the firm, that is us only. If it is our outlets, we must have invested. No, RST and XYZ were among the fastest growing outlets. Both of them are considering menus to include the pasta also. Purchase and installation of the necessary equipment will be costing 10,80,000 per outlet. Okay. Other information is as follows. Current investment, this is the thing. Okay. Revenue expense, you subtract both these things, you'll start to be getting your profit over here. Adding pasta in the menu will increase the profit by 183,600 for RST and 219,600 for XYZ outlet. Okay. If you add pasta, this will be your investment and this will be your extra income that will be there. The firm evaluates its manager's performance on the basis of return of investment. Okay. So therefore, these centers are investment centers. They are evaluated based upon ROI funda. Managers of individual outlets have the decisions over the pasta expansion. Okay. So for RST, we will have one manager. For XYZ, we have one manager. Those guys can decide, like, you know, that whether to do the expansion or not. Okay. What was the question? Calculate the ROI for both the outlets before pasta is added. Okay. For the pasta project only and for the outlets after the expansion. Now, this was very simple as such. Before pasta, it will be this particular figure. Okay. Divided by this particular figure into 100. Okay. That is one thing. For XYZ, it will be this minus this, that will give you the profit, divided by this into 100. That will be, in this case, the ROI that we were getting before. On pasta, how much will you get? 183,600 divided by 10,80,000 for RST. And in this case, for XYZ, it will be this figure upon 10,80,000 into 100. That will be that thing. And after this, okay, after this, if you will try to be seeing, I've printed the answers here. So after this, after you all do the expansion, no, then in that case, you can try to be doing like this. See, existing profits are there. Okay. Whatever is the increase you all try to be doing, new profits will start to be going. Current investment is there. You add up the increase in the investment. This will start to give you, in this case, the new investment. So therefore, these are your new profits. Apart from that, these are the new levels of investment. So therefore, try to calculate the new ROI. Now, earlier, if you all will see over here, earlier the ROI was 20% and 15%. But once you will be expanding the pasta range also, that becomes 19.5 and this particular figure is 15.5. So therefore, would you like to be expanding if you are evaluated based upon ROI funda? So earlier it was 20, it'll become 19.5 over here. So therefore, we would not like to be expanding because it falls down. And here we would like to be doing it because it increases from 15 to 15.5%. Okay. Now this was your part first of the question. Part second, assuming 14% cost of capital, calculate the residual income for both the outlets before and after the potential expansion. Now this was quite simple, and that is, How do you compute your ROI? Sorry, how do you compute your RI? RI is nothing but profit minus investment into COC. COC in this case is 14%, means after deducting cost of the funds, how much you are left off with. Okay. So what you all can be doing, see, revenue minus expense will give you the profit. This is your investment. On that, your cost of funds is 14% beta. So therefore, take your investment, multiply it by 14%, that is your cost of the funds. Subtract your revenue and expense, that gives you the profit that you must be having to before also. So whatever profit you get from there, you subtract the cost of capital, that will start to give you in this case your RI. See, that is whatever I have done. Existing profit we all have with us, that is the revenue minus expenses. Investment we all have, on that how much percent we all want? 14%. So therefore 14% comes to this. So this figure minus this particular figure will give you the residual income. This is RI concept. If you want to find out the same figure once you expand with the pasta, then in that case, new profits that you have already computed in part one, new investment that you have already calculated in part one into 14% over here. Okay, that will give you your cost of capital. So this figure minus this particular figure will give you the residual income over here. Okay, now see, in this case, no, residual income increases. So based upon RI concept, we would like to be doing the expansion. Okay, this was in this case your path second of the question. Path third, evaluate on the basis of ROI whether firms operated outlets RST and XYZ would choose to expand. I already answered that. For RST, it falls down from 20% to 19.5, so therefore they are not interested. For the other one, XYZ, it increases from 15 to 15.5%, so therefore they are interested. Okay. What difference would it make if the outlets were franchise? See, if suppose outlets were franchise, no, then it is very simple. As per me, franchisee business works like this only. I don't do the investment. Okay, company does not do the investment. The franchisee will do the investment. Whatever revenue those guys will be getting, part of that will be coming to us, will be directly added to my income. So therefore, our company's investment will not be there only, no extra investment, but your profits will increase. So ROI will automatically increase. So then in that particular case, S Limited will always be interested in that. That is whatever I've written over here. Okay, that is your this part. Further, now see, after that, part number four, Chetan is seeking investment funds to expand the chain of fast food. 200 outlets might be going to Shark Tank up and so on, which would be firm operated. Okay, he is currently in the process of putting together a business plan which will outline his strategy to increase the firm operated outlets. He recently attended a seminar on what to include in the business plan. Chetan remembers that he will need to determine what the critical success factors for his business are. What do you mean by CSF? These are your objectives that you have to achieve or you have achieved in past in order to get success. But he is confused. How do these differ from core competency? Core competency is there in our chapter number one. Core competencies in this case are like, you know, your capabilities to use your resources in a proper way. That is why every company has certain amount of core competency. For a small example, I always think my core competency is only one small thing. I can try to deliver the good content, the best content. I am pathetic in marketing. I don't try to be doing those particular things. So every business will have core competency. Okay. So CSF are the objectives that you would like to be achieving. Core competencies in this case, whatever you are good at, okay, how you all use your resources, what are your patents, what is, like, you know, your staff, like, you know, the intelligence level of your staff up and so on. Okay, now part A, assess why Chetan needs to identify the CSF as part of the strategy or development. How do they differ from core competency? I explained you that. Okay, and you can always try to write down all the points why CSF are necessary. Unless and until you determine the CSF, no, you will never ever have line of action also. Okay, you have to try to align your objectives with the vision of the company, that I want to be achieving this, I want to have a maximum amount of the profit share, or I want to be having good amount of market share, I want to be launching new products each and every year. Okay, like in this case, Mr. Chetan wants to be having the 100 outlet. Those are all the CSF as such. Okay, advise the possible CSF for Chetan's chain of fast food restaurants. Now I have mentioned lot of things over here which you all can. Okay, for a fast food restaurant, whatever you think that a company needs to be achieving, you can try to be writing down there. Quality and consistency. One small thing, they have not asked you mention the KPIs. They have only mentioned that try to find out the CSF. So whatever you think for a fast food restaurant is required. Okay, so quality of food I have given, then speed and efficiency. It's a fast food restaurant, so therefore try to deliver speed. Like for McDonald's, one of the best kind of a CSF is always that within 2 or 3 minutes they deliver you the food. For a fast food restaurant, that particular thing will matter. Then menu varieties and innovation, then competitive pricing is there, then customer service is there, strong branding and marketing. Apart from that, location and accessibility, efficient supply chain. Like you all might not be knowing, but McDonald's uses a special kind of a potato, okay, for making their french fries. For that, supply chain is so much required because you cannot purchase them from anywhere. So therefore those things will matter. Then technology, adaptability and flexibility. I mentioned 10 points, any 5 or 6 would have been more than enough as such. Okay, this was your that particular question. Okay, further. Now question number 4A, no, there was some company that was there which never ever involved the senior staff in their budgeting process. Now they want to be involving the senior staff also for this year. Those guys are saying mention 3 advantages and 2 disadvantages of involving the senior staff. Just a plain simple question, no case study question as such. So if you involve the senior staff, one thing, you start to be using their expertise and experience that is there. Second, if you involve the senior staff, they feel a sense of ownership because they are involved in the budgeting process. Third, in this case, collaboration and communication. When you involve the staff, no, the senior staff, those guys might be there from different teams. So cross-functioning starts to happen. The company always progresses more. But then the disadvantages are also there. It will become a time-consuming process because now this will be participative approaching. Okay, not a top-to-bottom approach, but a bottom-up approach. So that is one thing. Second thing in this case will be that is biases and personal interests. People start to think that budget should be made as per their convenience, not as per the vision of the company. So the personal bias and personal interest starts to be coming. A sales manager might always want that targets for him are not very high. So therefore he can try to achieve those budgets. So these are the problems that happen. Okay. Same way, for this question, you also had an option. There was a company that is following TQM and is about to be following Kaizen costing also. Okay, so therefore, there were two parts in this. Two basic principles of TQM you had to be doing. Now, in this case, no, for TQM, actually, I thought, what are the principles that I don't know, to be very honest. So therefore, I thought that ICA is actually asking the 6 C's. I think so. Okay. So I have mentioned the 6 C's over here. Okay. I call them as principles of TQM. I think so. This should have been the answer. Although not 100% sure what ICA means by that particular thing. Okay. And then see, this company also follows your standard costing approach, I think, but now they are about to be shifting. See, this line was there, but they are about to be shifting to Kaizen costing. So therefore, there was one part two over here that told you required 3 changes to the company's planning and control system to support the adoption of Kaizen costing. So therefore, in that case, I think I've given 2 only. I should have given 3, but that's okay. Now, I think I merged those 3 into 2 only. So first change is that your standard costing is a cost control system, not a cost reduction system. That is one thing. So Kaizen costing looks at we want to be cutting down the cost every now and then. Okay, but your standard costing system says we want to be controlling the cost. Second, the participation of the staff is required for Kaizen costing because everybody from top to low is involved in cost reduction. Okay, so you can mention these particular 2 points. I think if it was 3, I must have mentioned to something over here. You all can go through that. Okay, now this was your this question. Then further, part B. Now, this was all about your Kaizen costing, about your Pareto analysis. Now, almost similar kind of question we all have done. Now, we make some products over here. This is a telecom company. We have got complaints from the customer. You try to do your Pareto analysis. Okay. So, first of all, for Pareto analysis, it says that 80% of all the complaints will be because of 20% reasons. Okay. Try to find out those 20% reasons. You address them. Automatically, 80% complaints will go away. So, therefore, first of all, we arrange them in the descending order. So, automatically, top complaints come on the top. That is one thing. Second thing over here, you try to convert them into a percentage and then try to find out the cumulative one. That is till the time your 80% gets exhausted. You all can see the answer over here. So, what I did, I have prepared a frequency table. I arranged them in descending order first. Then I converted the percentage, all these particular things out of 100. And then I found out the cumulative. So till here, it was 80%. So major of the complaints are because of these kind of reasons. And in part two, these guys are only asking you that how should you use this data? So try to address these problems. If you address only these four categories of problems, no, 80% of all complaints will be going away. So that is whatever I mentioned over here. You can try to verify your answer by this. Okay. Now, again, just one small thing. I am only trying to do the things like, you know, basically as a cross check. If your attempt is November 2023, I would request you ask us the question paper, ask us the suggested paper and try to solve yourself and then see this particular video. It'll be more use to you. If I take 3.5 hours to be solving, it'll not be of any use to you all. So I'm just trying to discuss the structure of the paper and the final answers. Okay. This was your 4B. Then further, this is 4C. Now this 4C was very simple. We have this much amount of selling price, 7,000. This is my production cost, that is 5350. I sell to two types of customers, this guy and this guy. These many units I sell to him, these many units I sell to him. Okay. Now, number of purchase orders. We supply him 10 orders of 125 each, 20 orders of 125 each. Okay. We supply doors, I think. So therefore, these things are given. Number of deliveries. So 10 orders, 8 are normal orders and 2 are urgent or rushed orders. Over here, these things are zero. Why these things are zero? Because it is given that if a customer will pick up the goods himself, no, then in that case, we will not incur the delivery cost. But instead, we will try to be giving them some discount. That thing is given over here. This is exactly same as one of the questions that we all have done. Kilometers per delivery, 200 and 200. Okay. Order processing cost 3000 rupees per order. Normal delivery 20 rupees per kilometer. Rush delivery will become 30, so 1.5 times more. Product handling cost in this case will be 100 rupees per door. The company has a policy of giving 6% discount on selling price on orders of 100 doors or more. So I guess both of them are ordering 125. So both of them will be getting this discount. This will be kind of bulk discount. And further give 10% discount on undiscounted selling price if the customer uses his own transport to take the delivery of the factory gate. So I guess this customer, no, okay, takes his own delivery because number of deliveries that we have done to him is zero. If he has placed 20 orders, but we have not delivered him, okay, that means he is using his own transport. He will be getting 10% discount on the undiscounted price. So therefore, they'll be getting a discount of 7,000 bucks. Okay. 7,000 into 10%, that is 700 rupees. Further, calculate the contribution and profit per unit for each customer. Okay. So what I did for this answer, no, two types of customers, their normal, we sell to them at this particular rate, but trade discount we give to both of them. But delivery discount we only give to the second customer because he uses his own transport. This will give you the net selling price. From there you subtract the production cost. This will give you the contribution. Multiply by number of units, this will start to give you the total contribution less your overhead cost. Order processing cost. Order processing cost will get incurred at the rate of 3000 rupees per order. 3000 per order into 10 orders. 3000 rupees per order into 20 orders. So accordingly, this was supposed to be your cost. Normal delivery cost of 32,000. I must have calculated how. I try to do him 8 normal deliveries. So therefore, 8 deliveries into. He is how far, beta? 200 kilometers. And it cost me in this case, how much rupees per kilometer? 20 over here. So therefore, into 20. That is how I think so answer would have come over here. So 200 into 20 will be giving you 4000 into 8. So 32,000. For this thing, it will become zero. Product handling cost in this case is rupees 10 per door. So therefore 1250 sorry, 100 rupees per dose. So 1250 into 100, that will be giving you all this answer. And over there, 2500 into 100. Then rush delivery will be two deliveries for him into 200 kilometers into rupees 30. I think this is how this particular thing comes. So this is a profit that you earn from this guy. This is a profit that you earn from this guy. They want profit per dose. So therefore, divide by the number of units, you get this. Okay. Now, part two, those guys have asked you the analysis. You can write big. I've just given the final answer. If you think this guy is buying double quantity as compared to this guy, but you earn far more profit from the first guy as compared to the second guy in absolute terms, even in per unit terms, no, you earn approximately more than double as compared to this kind of a customer. Okay, so therefore, although this guy is buying half the quantity as compared to this guy, you are earning double. Let me put it in the opposite way. You are selling double to this particular customer, you are earning very less profits from there, and obviously the difference between both of them is nothing but this kind of a price. For that only, sorry, this kind of a discount. Now for this only, you have to try to be commenting in end that, like, you know, you try to comment on that. So therefore, what did I think? If suppose we would have delivered 20 orders to this particular customer also, okay, if we would have delivered 20 customers, assuming that those were normal deliveries, so therefore 20 into 200 kilometers into, in this case, rupees 20 per kilometer. If you calculate this, okay, and then in this case, if you divide by number of units 2500 that I worked below over here, that thing will be approximately coming to 32 per unit. Even if all the 20 deliveries were urgent deliveries, that is rush delivery, it will be still coming to only 48 per unit. So if suppose you will be supplying, you will be delivering to them, okay, then it will cost you minimum 32 if suppose it is a normal delivery, maximum 48 if it is a rush delivery. To save this 32 or 48, you are giving them a discount of 700 rupees per unit, which is exorbitant, okay. But the thing is now that customer is already used to such kind of a discount. You suddenly cannot tell to our customer, from tomorrow we will only deliver and we will not give you this kind of a discount over here, because customer is used to this. If you tell him this particular statement right now, he will stop to buy from you. Then in that case, what to do? You can try to be saying that let's try to phase out such kind of discounts over a period of time. कोई भी चीज सडनली वो करते हो ना, कस्टमर को बुरा लगता है, लेकिन ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम करते हो तो बुरा नहीं लगता. एग्जाम्पल, अभी फ्लिपकार्ट वगैरह शुरू में हमेशा डिलीवरी फ्री रखते थे, लेकिन अभी हर चीज के ऊपर डिलीवरी फ्री नहीं है. फॉर सम गुड्स दे ऑल चार्ज ऑल्सो. अभी अपने को इतना बुरा वो नहीं लगता, बिकॉज दैट हैज हैपेंड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. ओके, सो एंश्योर दैट यू ऑल डू नॉट लूज द कस्टमर. ओके, चलिए, दिस वॉज क्वेश्चन नंबर 5A. दिस वॉज ऑन स्टैंडर्ड कॉस्टिंग. Standard costing, actual sales from 14,300 units was there. Direct materials, direct labor, variable overhead. These were all your actual data. Total cost was there. Actual profit was over here. Okay. Standard cost per unit of material is 15. Material का ना इस question के अंदर कुछ भी breakup वगैरह नहीं पूछा हुआ था और दिया भी नहीं हुआ था. बस यही data है कि standard cost is 15 per unit. ठीक है. अगर एक्चुअल कॉस्ट निकालने के लिए जाओ तो निकाल सकते हो दिस फिगर अपॉन 14,300, बट इट वाज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड एज सच. ओके, स्टैंडर्ड वेज रेट इज 10.5 पर आर. स्टैंडर्ड वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स रेट इज 12.5 पर आर. ठीक है. द कंपनी यूजेस जीआईटी सिस्टम एंड प्रोडक्शन एंड बजटेड प्रोडक्शन एंड सेल्स क्वांटिटीज 15,000. तो हम लोगों ने सोचा था कितना यूनिट्स बनाकर बेचेंगे, 15,000. एक्चुअल के अंदर बेटा कितना बेचा, 14,300. ठीक है. पर्टिकुलर्स, the following variances were recorded during the last quarter. Okay, so in this case something like this. Material cost variance, uska breakup nahi hai, not required. Labor rate variance hai, labor efficiency variance hai, which we will try to be using. फिर उसके बाद वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स के दोनों वराइंसेस अपने को पूछा हुआ है. सेल्स वराइंसेस, उन लोगों ने अपने को दोनों वराइंसेस पूछे हुए हैं. ठीक है, एक सेकेंड. वेरिएबल ओवरहेड का एक्सपेंडिचर वराइंस कैसे कैलकुलेट होता है, कि रेट क्या होना चाहिए था, रेट क्या था इंटू एक्चुअल आवर्स. फिर उसके बाद एफिशिएंसी वेरिएंस कैसे कंप्यूट होता है, एक्चुअल आउटपुट के लिए कितना आर्स लेना चाहिए था, कितना आर्स लिया इनटू स्टैंडर्ड वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स का रेट. ठीक है. सेल्स वॉल्यूम वेरिएंस कैसे कंप्यूट होता है, कितना यूनिट्स बेचना चाहिए था माइनस कितना यूनिट्स बेचा इनटू स्टैंडर्ड सेलिंग प्राइस. ओके, तो आपको वो वाला जो डेटा है वो कैलकुलेट वो करना पड़ेगा टू कैलकुलेट दिस. अपने को रिक्वायर्ड पार्ट क्या था, कैलकुलेट द मिसिंग वेरिएंसेस एंड प्रिपेयर द ओरिजिनल बजट एंड रिकनसाइल द थिंग्स ऑल्सो. वन ऑफ द इजिएस्ट क्वेश्चंस ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड कॉस्टिंग जो आईसी ने आज तक पूछा है. देखो, लेबर रेट वेरिएंस हमारे पास क्वेश्चन के अंदर था, वो कैसे कंप्यूट होता है स्टैंडर्ड रेट पर आर. minus actual rate per hour into actual hours. I have opened the bracket to arrive at the answer. Te paas 10.3 hai, actual hours ka data nahi hai. Minus actual rate per hour into actual hours will be giving you the actual cost. This has to be equal to 2640. This figure I found out as a balancing figure. 16680 was your answer. Okay. So therefore, actual hours maine is format ke andar yahan par wo dal diye. Theek hai? Achha, maine ek aur cheez bhi yahan par to wo nikala. Actual rate not required, but I did that. Okay, actual rate in this case will be 172,500 upon 16680. Actually, usko fractions ke andar hi rakhoge to acha hai, but I have just written over here 10.34 ke aaspas. Theek hai, this is actual rate apne paas aa gaya. To dekho, ye apne paas amount tha, ye hours aa gaye, to apne paas ye wala rate bhi aa gaya. Ye wala 10.5 apne paas tha, lekin ek aur variance hai, labor efficiency variance. Kitna hours lagna chahiye tha, kitna hours laga into standard rate. Aapke paas ye data nahi hai, lekin ye डेटा है, ये डेटा है, सो देयरफॉर ये वाला वेरिएंस भी तो है. आई फाउंड आउट दिस एज अ बैलेंसिंग फिगर 17160. फिर उसके बाद स्टैंडर्ड आर्स मेरे पास वो आ गया. स्टैंडर्ड आर्स एक बार वो आ गया तो मैंने एक काम जरा किया, इसको इससे डिवाइड वो कर लिया, तो मेरे को यहां पे ना स्टैंडर्ड आर्स पर यूनिट 1.2 आर्स आ गया. ठीक है, अब इसके बाद वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स के फॉर्मेट के लिए जरा सोचो. दीज आर्स ओनली गेट कॉपीड ओवर हियर, दीज आर्स विल ओनली गेट कॉपीड बिकॉज देयर इज नो आइडल टाइम. ये वाला रेट जो है ये क्वेश्चन के अंदर ही है, ये वाला वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स का जो अमाउंट है ये तो क्वेश्चन के अंदर ही है. दिस इज अ बैलेंसिंग फिगर एंड दिस इज वट एवर आई कंप्यूटेड. आप लोग अपने वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स के दो वेरिएंसेस कंप्यूट कर सकते हो, एक्सपेंडिचर वेरिएंस दिस रेट माइनस दिस रेट इनटू दीज आवर्स. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट वेरिएबल ओवरहेड का एफिशिएंसी वेरिएंस दीज आवर्स माइनस दीज आवर्स इनटू दिस पर्टिकुलर रेट. ओके, अच्छा फिर आपके पास क्वेश्चन के ना सेलिंग प्राइस वेरिएंस था. यूज दैट सेलिंग प्राइस वेरिएंस टू फाइंड आउट योर स्टैंडर्ड सेलिंग प्राइस. द स्टैंडर्ड सेलिंग प्राइस विल बी कमिंग टू 85. एक बार स्टैंडर्ड सेलिंग प्राइस वो आ गया, आप लोग सेल्स वॉल्यूम वेरिएंस निकाल सकते हो. कैसे, कितना यूनिट्स बेचना चाहिए था 15,000, कितना बेचा 14,300 इंटू 85 रुपीज. सो देयरफॉर दिस विल बी योर एडवर्स वेरिएंस बिकॉज यू हैव सोल्ड लेसर अमाउंट ऑफ क्वांटिटी. ओके, सुन अभी इसके बाद ना मैंने एक और चीज भी निकाला है, सेल्स मार्जिन वॉल्यूम वेरिएंस, दैट इज प्रॉफिट वॉल्यूम वेरिएंस. वो कैसे कंप्यूट होता है, कितना यूनिट्स बेचना चाहिए था माइनस कितना यूनिट्स बेचा इंटू स्टैंडर्ड प्रॉफिट पर यूनिट. आई विल करेक्ट दैट. ओके, स्टैंडर्ड प्रॉफिट पर यूनिट. ओके, नाउ सी स्टैंडर्ड प्रॉफिट पर यूनिट ना मैंने इधर निकालने का ट्राई किया. स्टैंडर्ड प्रॉफिट पर यूनिट तो कैसे आएगा बेटा, स्टैंडर्ड सेलिंग प्राइस 85 माइनस 15 जो मटेरियल कॉस्ट जो क्वेश्चन के अंदर ही है, माइनस स्टैंडर्ड लेबर कॉस्ट. This data upon this data will give you standard labor cost per unit. This data upon this particular data will be giving you standard variable overheads per unit. If you'll work on your calci, that'll be coming to this and this. So standard profit is 42.4 per unit. 42.4 per unit मैंने यहाँ पर use किया. This will be the answer. ठीक है, उसके बाद दो काम था, ओरिजिनल बजट निकालो. ओरिजिनल बजट ओरिजिनली सोचा था इतना यूनिट्स बेचेंगे एट दिस मच प्राइस. मटेरियल्स एट द रेट ऑफ 15 पर यूनिट, सो 15,000 यूनिट्स एट द रेट ऑफ 15 पर यूनिट विल बी गिविंग यू ऑल दिस. हर यूनिट के लिए 1.2 आवर्स लगना चाहिए था, तो 15,000 के लिए 18,000 आवर्स एट द रेट ऑफ 10.5, यहाँ पे भी 18,000 आवर्स एट द रेट ऑफ 12.5. ओके, नाउ रिको स्टेटमेंट के लिए मेरे को प्रॉफिट वॉल्यूम वेरिएंस की जरूरत थी, इसलिए मैंने इधर प्रॉफिट वॉल्यूम वेरिएंस बेटा निकाला. ठीक है, प्रॉफिट वॉल्यूम वेरिएंस इन दिस केस, तो यू ऑल स्टार्ट अवे विद बजटेड प्रॉफिट 15,000 इंटू 42.4. ओके, फिर उसके बाद इन दिस केस नेट प्रॉफिट वेरिएंस ड्यू टू चेंज इन सेल्स योर सेलिंग प्राइस वेरिएंस दैट यू हैड इन द क्वेश्चन, प्रॉफिट वॉल्यूम वेरिएंस जो आप लोगों ने वो निकाल लिया, फिर मटेरियल वाला वेरिएंस तो क्वेश्चन के अंदर ही था, उसके बाद लेबर रेट एंड एफिशिएंसी क्वेश्चन के अंदर ही था, वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स का रेट एंड एफिशिएंसी वेरिएंस आप लोगों ने वो किया. दिस इज योर फाइनल आंसर एंड दिस प्रॉफिट विल मैच विद द प्रॉफिट जो अपने पास क्वेश्चन के अंदर ही था. मेरे ख्याल से क्वेश्चन के अंदर अपने पास बेटा ये वाला प्रॉफिट तो था ना, सो इन एनी केस एवरीथिंग इज ऑल टुगेदर फाइन. ओके, ये हो गया तुम्हारा ये वाला क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, अभी जो नेक्स्ट वाला क्वेश्चन था ना, वन ऑफ द सिंपलेस्ट क्वेश्चन इन डिसीजन मेकिंग, ध्यान से सुनना. अपना कैपेसिटी जो था ना वो 10,000 यूनिट्स का था, बट करंटली वी वर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग 7,500 यूनिट्स एंड वी वर डूइंग सेल्स ऑफ 7,50,000, मतलब अपना जो सेलिंग प्राइस था वो 100 था. ठीक है, लेकिन हम लोग करंटली इतना ही यूज करते थे. अभी सामने अपने को क्या बोला, एक कस्टमर अपने पास आता है, वो अपने को क्या बोलता है कि ना इन दिस केस अपने को यहाँ पे 5,000 यूनिट्स इन दिस केस और बनाकर बेचो. ठीक है, तो 5000 अगर और लेगा एडेड टू 7500 इट बिकम 12500. सो देयरफॉर इन दैट केस मेरी उतनी कैपेसिटी तो नहीं है. उन लोगों ने क्या बोला, अगर आपको कैपेसिटी बढ़ानी है एक इक्विपमेंट वो खरीद लेना 5 लाख रुपीज का, दैट विल बी हैविंग अ लाइफ स्पैन ऑफ कितना ईयर्स, 10 ईयर्स. ठीक है, अगर वो कर लोगे तो इन दैट केस यू विल बी एबल टू एक्सेप्ट दी ऑफर. तो एक ऑप्शन वो ये है, लेकिन ये जो 5000 वो यूनिट है ना वो नॉर्मल प्राइस के ऊपर नहीं बिकेंगे, दोज विल बी एट 90% ऑफ द प्रेजेंट सेलिंग प्राइस. सो देयरफॉर वो 100 के ऊपर नहीं बिकेंगे, वो 90 के ऊपर बिकेंगे. ये ऑप्शन हम लोग नेक्स्ट ईयर के लिए सोच रहे हैं, लेकिन नेक्स्ट ईयर ना अपना मटेरियल कॉस्ट 10% से बढ़ रहा है, लेबर कॉस्ट 25% से बढ़ रहा है, फिक्स्ड ओवरहेड तुम्हारा 25,000 से बढ़ रहा है. ठीक है, उन लोगों ने ना क्या किया हुआ है, देखो करंटली अपना जो सेलिंग प्राइस है ना बेटा वो 100 है, दैट इज दिस फिगर अपॉन दिस फिगर. उसके में से 30 रुपीज तेरा मटीरियल कॉस्ट है, 20 रुपीज तेरा वो लेबर कॉस्ट है, एंड 10 रुपीज इज योर वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स पर यूनिट. ठीक है, और करंटली तुम लोग प्रॉफिट कितना कमाते हो, दैट इज 16.65 पर यूनिट. उन लोगों ने ना करंटली डेटा के अंदर सेल्स दिया, उन लोगों ने मटेरियल दिया, लेबर दिया, वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स दिया और प्रॉफिट दिया. सो फिक्स्ड ओवरहेड्स विल बी योर बैलेंसिंग फिगर. ठीक है, सो दैट इज व्हाट एवर आई हैव डन. मैंने ना टाइम पास के लिए एक लास्ट ईयर का स्टेटमेंट वो बनाया है, सेल्स, उसके बाद मटेरियल, लेबर एंड वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स इज देयर विद यू, प्रॉफिट है मेरे पास 16.65 के हिसाब से, सो फिक्स्ड ओवरहेड्स विल बी योर बैलेंसिंग फिगर. ठीक है, अभी नेक्स्ट ईयर के लिए ना मेरे पास दो ऑप्शन है, या मैं वो वाला ऑफर एक्सेप्ट कर लूं, ठीक है, या फिर वो लोगों ने क्या बोला, जो तेरा 2500 का अनयूज्ड कैपेसिटी है ना तो उसको यूज कर लेना और एक्स्ट्रा एडवर्टाइजमेंट कॉस्ट का खर्चा कर, दैट विल कॉस्ट यू 30,000. तो तेरे पास नेक्स्ट ईयर के लिए दो ऑप्शन है. ठीक है, दो ऑप्शन वो क्या है इन दिस केस, ऑफर एक्सेप्ट कर लो, 12,500 यूनिट्स बनाओ, या फिर बैलेंस अनयूज कैपेसिटी यूज करके 10,000 यूनिट बना लो, दैट इज वॉट एवर इज अ क्वेश्चन. मैंने यहाँ पे टाइम पास के लिए बस नेक्स्ट ईयर का डेटा थोड़ा बहुत वो रिकॉर्ड किया है, बट दिस कॉलम एज सच इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, इज जस्ट फॉर योर रेफरेंस एंड नथिंग एल्स, इसलिए मैंने यहाँ पे वो लिख भी दिया है नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. ठीक है, तो 12,500, 7,500 यूनिट्स विल बी सोल्ड एट 100, तो दिस विल बी द सेल्स. फिर उसके बाद 5000 यूनिट्स विल बी सोल्ड एट 90, सो दिस विल बी द सेल्स. मटेरियल कॉस्ट पिछले साल 30 था, 10% से बढ़ जाएगा, ये 25% से बढ़ जाएगा. वेरिएबल ओवरहेड्स के ना कोई चेंज नहीं है, तो वो 10 रुपीज ही रहेगा. ठीक है, फिक्स्ड ओवरहेड्स हमारा 25,000 रुपीज से बढ़ जाएगा, सो दिस फिगर आई हैव इंक्रीज बाय 25,000. ठीक है, लेकिन अगर तूने ये वाला ऑर्डर एक्सेप्ट किया, 5 लाख रुपए का इक्विपमेंट की जरूरत पड़ेगी, लाइफ ऑफ 10 ईयर्स, सो अगर पर ईयर के हिसाब से कैलकुलेट वो करो, यू कैन टेक से 50,000. ठीक है, सो देयरफॉर दिस विल बी योर प्रॉफिट. लेकिन अगर दूसरे ऑप्शन के लिए गए तो जरा सोचो, 7500 यूनिट्स आल्सो विल बी सोल्ड एट 100, रिमेनिंग 2500 विल आल्सो बी सोल्ड एट 100, ऑल दीस पर्टिकुलर थिंग्स इन दिस केस, ये वाले जो कॉस्ट है विल गेट इनकर्ड फॉर 10,000 यूनिट्स. तुम्हारा फिक्स्ड ओवरहेड्स जो है इन दिस केस वो 25,000 रुपीस से बढ़ जाएगा. ठीक है, सो दिस इज वन थिंग. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, यहाँ पे तुम्हारा ये वाला जो फिगर है इन दिस केस वो एडवर्टाइजमेंट कॉस्ट वाला जो वो नंबर है वो 30,000 रुपीज़ है. ठीक है, अच्छा एक चीज़ मेरे को करेक्ट वो करने दो, आई एम नॉट वेरी श्योर, अ प्रोस्पेक्टिव कस्टमर. हाँ देखो, उन लोगों ने क्या बोला था, अगर ऑर्डर फॉर 5000 यूनिट्स एक्सेप्ट किया ना, फिक्स्ड ओवरहेड्स 25,000 रुपीज से बढ़ जाएगा एक्स्ट्रा ड्यू टू इंक्रीज्ड एडमिन एक्सपेंसेस. तो ये वाला 25,000 वो तभी बढ़ेगा जब इन दिस केस आप लोग ऑर्डर एक्सेप्ट करोगे. तो मैंने क्या किया, ये 1,75,125 जो था ना, ये वाला चीज एक बार बढ़ेगा 25,000 रुपीज से, क्योंकि अपना फिक्स्ड ओवरहेड्स ही बढ़ रहा है, दैट इज वन थिंग. सेकेंड पर्टिकुलर थिंग इन दिस केस की ना, 25,000 से और बढ़ जाएगा बिकॉज ऑफ द एडमिन चार्जेस, सो देयरफॉर इन ऑल इट विल बी बिकमिंग दिस मच. यहां पर जो प्रॉफिट है वो इतना आता है, यहां पर जो है वो इतना आता है, सो देयरफॉर दिस फिगर इज हायर, दैट इज नॉट बी द बेस्ट ऑप्शन. ठीक है, नाउ ये हो गया तुम्हारा ये वाला क्वेश्चन. फिर उसके बाद क्वेश्चन नंबर 6A आया. नाउ यहाँ पे ना आप लोगों की कंपनी है जो गेमिंग कंसोल्स वगैरह वो बनाता है, समथिंग लाइक द एक्सबॉक्स एंड सो ऑन. ठीक है, तो ये लोगों ने यहाँ पर क्या किया था कि ना, हम लोग सोच रहे हैं एक नया गेमिंग कंसोल जो है वो लॉन्च करेगा एट सेलिंग प्राइस ऑफ 21,000. ये लोग ऐसा वो सोचता है. ठीक है, 21,000 पे आप लोग 2,000 यूनिट्स पर मंथ का डिमांड आएगा. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, फॉर एवरी 2,000 रुपीज इंक्रीज इन सेलिंग प्राइस द मंथली डिमांड विल बी रिड्यूसिंग बाई 250. दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑन थियरी ऑफ प्रॉफिट मैक्सिमाइजेशन, अगर याद होएगा तो, दैट इज P इज इक्वल टू A माइनस बी क्यू. यहाँ पे क्यू के बदले में उन लोगों ने एक्स वो लिखा था. And for every 2,000 rupees decrease in selling price, the monthly demand will be increasing by 250 units. ठीक है, The variable cost for one product of this kind of a gaming console will be this, ठीक है? इसका total कर लेंगे तो 17,000 आ जाता है. Now ये लोग क्या plan कर रहा है? APR is planning digital marketing campaign for this particular product. The total cost of the marketing campaign is yet to be finalized. However, after deducting the cost of the digital marketing, the company requires a minimum profit of this much. तो वो लोग क्या बोलता है, एडवर्टाइजमेंट कॉस्ट लेस करने के बाद भी अपने को इतना प्रॉफिट तो चाहिए इन द इंट्रोडक्टरी फेज. और ना उन लोगों ने लिखा हुआ था इंट्रोडक्टरी फेज विल बी लास्टिंग फॉर 3 months बेटा. और यहां पे जो चीज था ना वो पर मंथ था. देर आर नो अदर स्पेसिफिक फिक्स कॉस्ट विद दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट. कैलकुलेट द मैक्सिमम प्रॉफिट फॉर डिजिटल मार्केटिंग कैंपेन दैट दिस गाय रिक्वायर्स. सो देयरफॉर सॉरी कैलकुलेट द मैक्सिमम कॉस्ट फॉर द डिजिटल मार्केटिंग कैंपेन. वो लोग तुमको ये पूछ रहे हैं, हम लोगों ने प्रॉफिट तो दिया हुआ है, तुम लोग मैक्सिमम कितना डिजिटल मार्केटिंग के ऊपर खर्चा कर सकते हो. और उन लोगों ने क्या लिखा, द कंपनी विल सेट द प्राइस फॉर अ यूनिट टू मैक्सिमाइज द प्रॉफिट ड्यूरिंग द इंट्रोडक्टरी फेसेस. देखो ये वाला जो चीज है ये थियरी ऑफ प्रॉफिट मैक्सिमाइजेशन के ऊपर है. पी इज इक्वल टू ए माइनस बी एक्स, एक्स मतलब क्यू इन योर इक्वेशंस, ओके, एंड एम आर इज इक्वल टू ए माइनस टू बी एक्स. देखो अभी हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं कि प्रॉफिट इज हाईएस्ट व्हेन एमआर इज इक्वल टू एमसी. यू ऑल हैव डन दिस थिंग, एमआर इज इक्वल टू एमसी. तो मैंने यहां पर क्या किया, प्रॉफिट इज हाईएस्ट व्हेन एमआर इज इक्वल टू एमसी. ए का मतलब क्या होता है, प्राइस एट विच डिमांड इज जीरो, ओके. नाउ इस क्वेश्चन के अंदर ए नहीं दिया हुआ था, ये लोगों ने क्या बोला था, अगर 21,000 रुपीज का सेलिंग प्राइस है ना तो वहां पे 2,000 यूनिट जो है वो बिक सकता है, ठीक है. उन लोगों ने ऐसा अपने को दिया हुआ था, ठीक है, मेरे ख्याल से यहां पर 2000 रुपीज विल बी द डिमांड, 2000 यूनिट्स विल बी द डिमांड पर मंथ. और उन लोगों ने उसके बाद क्या लिखा, जब भी आप लोग जो सेलिंग प्राइस है 2000 से बढ़ाओगे ना, आपका जो डिमांड है वो कितने से कम हो जाएगा, 250 यूनिट से. तो अगर 1 यूनिट से कम करने का है, दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग हैज टू बी इंक्रीजिंग बाय 8, ओके. अगर तुम लोग को याद होएगा दिस इज बी का वैल्यू, बी मतलब स्लोप ऑफ डिमांड, मतलब एक यूनिट का डिमांड अगर बढ़ाने का है तो प्राइस कितने से कम करना पड़ेगा या वाइस वर्सा. सो देयरफॉर दैट विल बी कमिंग टू 8 रुपीस. ए का मतलब क्या होता है, प्राइस एट विच डिमांड इज जीरो. तो सी योर बी इज नथिंग बट डिमांड ऑफ द कर्व, ओके. सो देयरफॉर दैट विल बी नथिंग बट रुपीज 8. नाउ एट 21,000 डिमांड विल बी हाउ मच बेटा, 2,000. बट व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ए, ए इज दैट पर्टिकुलर प्राइस एट विच डिमांड इज जीरो. सो सी एट 21,000 डिमांड इज हाउ मच, 2,000. सो इफ आई वॉन्ट टू रिड्यूस डिमांड बाय 2000, so therefore it becomes zero. I'll have to increase the price, no? So that is whatever I have done over here. At 21,000, the demand is 2000 units. For every rupees 250, just a sec. For every rupees, not 250, I think this is 2000, okay. For every 2000 increase in selling price, the demand decreases by 250 units, okay. So to make the demand zero, selling price will have to increase by 2000. You can directly do into 8 also. Okay. So therefore, selling price has to be increasing by 16,000. I hope you all understood this. At 21,000, demand will be how much? 2000. So if suppose I have to make this demand zero, I'll have to make demand fall by how much, beta? 2000. 8 in this case is nothing but slope of the demand curve. So therefore, if I want to sell or if I want to sell one less unit, I'll have to increase the selling price by 8. So if I want to demand the, if I want to reduce the demand by 2000, I'll have to increase the selling price by how much? That'll be nothing but 2000 into 8, no? So 16,000. So 21,000 is the current price plus 16,000. So therefore 37,000. So A in this case will be 37,000 over here. Okay. That is the price at which demand will be zero. Now theory of profit maximization says what, beta? Profit is highest when MR is equal to MC. MR is A minus 2BX is equal to MC. MC means your marginal cost, means your variable cost. Okay. So A is 37,000 minus 2BX is equal to 17,000. Work out your X. X will be 1250 units per month. Okay. Or for the introduction stage, which will be lasting for 3 months, it will become 3750. Then P is equal to A minus BX. A is nothing but 37,000, but you will be producing 1250 units, no? So 1250 into 8, your price will have to get reduced by this much. So therefore, your pricing will be 27,000. Okay. Now, those guys have told you, calculate the amount on digital advertisement for 3 months. So sales will be 27,000 rupees ka selling price into 3750 units. Then less your variable cost, your 17,000 into 3750, you compute your contribution, subtract your profit. Okay, which is there in the question, I think. This will give you, this is a maximum amount on advertisement that you all can incur as such. Okay. Now, in part 2, no. I'm sorry, I'm a bit in a hurry because I just want to be explaining the concept. Okay. Now, in part 2, no. What those guys have told. Discuss two reasons why it might not be appropriate to set the introduction price of this product using the assumptions contained in profit maximization model. See, profit maximization model no, should only be followed where demand elasticity is there, where demand elasticity, that is, if you reduce the prices, no, the selling price will increase. I think demand console, which is very unique, it was given to you right in the beginning. It has many new features. Okay, that thing was given over here. Company's first thing featuring unique technology. Now, such kind of unique products, okay, we might not follow this theory for it. That theory should only be followed where demand elasticity is there. Demand elasticity means if you ever reduce the price, the demand is going to be increasing. This product, which is an introduction product, this product, which is very advanced product, this product, like, you know, which is actually purchased for fun, okay, which is actually purchased for fun, might not qualify for such kind of a thing. So therefore, the prices for such products should always be done thinking that what the customer can be paying and not based upon this model. Okay, that is whatever you should try to be writing in part B over here. Okay, now that is whatever I've written over here. Okay, then question number six part B was on budgetary control, whereby currently we are following one kind of a approach in this case, and now we are trying to be thinking, instead of following a top-down approach, should we follow a participative approach or not? So therefore, this question was all about that, and that is whatever I've tried to write. It was a simple question. If you'll try to read this entire question, there are no numbers as such, okay, but the required part speaks lot amount of things as such. So you go through the question which is there, and then in that case, like, you know, you can try to be commenting about all the question, all the parts that are over here. Okay, I'll read some part of the question, not the complete one. See what those guys have told. There is some limited, there is some company that produces milk and sells it under this brand name. Then the company operates on a financial year basis, begins its annual budgeting process in the last week of March, when the CEO establishes the targets for the total sales revenue and net. So therefore, the budgets are made by the CEO only. Okay, it is not made by other people. It is made by the CEO only. Okay, and the net operating income before taxes for the next year. So therefore, currently now, I think these guys are following top to down approach. The sales target is then given to all the managers up and so on. Okay, marketing department head is called as Charan. He is given the target, then all other people are given the target up and so on. So therefore, it is a top-down approach. Now the question says that particular thing only, that identify the budgeting approach. So therefore, it is a top-down approach which is there. That's your answer to part one. Evaluate why original budget failed to achieve, because these budgets are imposed on the people, okay, and the managers do not have any say in the budgets. So therefore, the budgets are imposed. So therefore, in end, these budgets might prove to be very bad budgets, because these are not made by the managers. These are made by the owners who might not know what is happening in the reality. So try to do that. Discuss the key features of participatory budgetary approach. So therefore, instead of following top to down, follow a bottom up approach, that is participative approach. Try to follow that. Further, evaluate why sales estimates have been understated and projected purchases by the marketing head up and so on. See, one of the disadvantages now of participative approach is that every manager would like to introduce budget slack. Now, budget slack was there in our budgetary control ka chapter also. Budgetary slack ka matlab kya hota hai? Koi ek sales manager tha, wo na 100 rupees ka sales kar sakta tha, usko malum hai. लेकिन उसने बजट अप्रूव कर दिया एट 80, उसने बजट अप्रूव वो करवा लिया फ्रॉम द टॉप पीपल एट 80, तो उसने क्या किया, उसने ना 20 का स्लैक इंट्रोड्यूस कर दिया। अभी जब वो एक्चुअल सेल्स करेगा तो वो कितने का सेल्स कर पाएगा, 100, लेकिन बजट अप्रूव हुआ था एट व्हाट पर्टिकुलर प्राइस, 80। सो देयरफॉर एवरीबॉडी विल थिंक ही इज अ ग्रेट मैनेजर यार, क्योंकि बजट था 80 का, उसने अचीव कितना कर लिया, 100। दिस आर ऑल द डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ पार्टिसिपेटिव अप्रोचिंग वेयर बाय द मैनेजर्स ट्राई टू इंट्रोड्यूस बजट स्लैक। वो लोग बजट्स को जानबूझ के अंडरस्टेट करवा देते हैं ताकि दे ऑल परफॉर्म फार बेटर एंड दे ऑल गेट द बोनसेस। ठीक है, यही वाला चीज उन लोगों ने यहां पे पार्ट 5 के अंदर भी पूछा, दैट इन दिस केस व्हाट इज मेंट बाय बजटरी स्लैक ओवर हियर। मैंने वही वाला चीज भी एक्सप्लेन किया, दिस इज स्लाइटली अ थ्योरी काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग, बट यू ऑल कुड हैव रिटन दीज थिंग्स। ओके, मैंने बहुत डिटेल के अंदर दिया है, आप लोग यहां पे उसको कंसाइज भी कर सकते हो। अच्छा सुन, अभी इसके बाद क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 आया। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 जो था ना, इट इज़ अ वेरी बिग क्वेश्चन। मैं वो वाला क्वेश्चन, नॉट टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट, बहुत ज़्यादा डिस्कस वो नहीं करने वाला हूँ। इट वॉज ऑन सप्लाई चेन मैनेजमेंट। कोई एक कंपनी है जो फास्ट फैशन के अंदर है, ओके, जो फैशन मतलब जो क्लोथिंग वगैरह वो बनाता है फॉर वुमेन एज बिटवीन 20 to 35। कंपनी की ये तीन फिलोसफीज हैं, उसके अंदर से ये वाला जो फिलॉसफी है ना वो तुम्हारे SCM के 8 अप्रोचेस के अंदर से एक अप्रोच के अंदर है, कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप मैनेजमेंट, क्योंकि पार्ट 1 उसके ऊपर था। फिर उसके बाद ये कंपनी इज अ लीडर, लेकिन ना टेक्नोलॉजी वगैरह ज़्यादा अडॉप्ट नहीं करते। अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट दे फॉलो अ पुल सिस्टम, मतलब जब डिमांड आया ये लोग तभी बनाएंगे और शॉर्ट शॉर्ट साइकिल्स के अंदर ही बनाएंगे। पूरा का पूरा जो क्वेश्चन था इसी चीज के ऊपर था। फिर ये लोग की जो कंपनी है रिसर्च वगैरह वो कैसे करता है, लाइक ये फैशन कंपनी है, सो दे विजिट द कॉलेजेस, दे विजिट द ऑफिसेस, दे विजिट द डिस्को बार्स, द पब्स अप एंड सो ऑन, एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट व्हाट द गर्ल्स वेयर, और उसके हिसाब से दे ऑल ट्राई टू बी प्रोड्यूसिंग। बहुत ज्यादा प्रोड्यूस नहीं करते हैं क्योंकि एल्स स्टॉक्स विल बी देयर अ लॉट, और एंड के ना डिस्काउंट्स वगैरह तो वो देना पड़ेगा। तो इन लोग का सारा जो डेटा है ना वो कॉम्पिटिटर से बहुत अच्छा है। Inventory turnover ratio is very high, so stocks get sold faster. Apart from that, in this case, इनके बहुत सारे physical stores हैं, and customer visit their stores 12 times in a year as compared to the competitors, which are only 3 times. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट ये लोग ना बहुत ज्यादा डिस्काउंट भी नहीं देते। 80 दे सेल अप्रॉक्सीमेटली एट 85% ऑफ देयर प्राइसेस, वाइल द अदर कॉम्पिटिटर्स आर गिविंग ह्यूज डिस्काउंट, सेल एट 65%। ओके, तो बहुत सारे वो एडवांटेजेस हैं, बट ओनली थिंग इज दे आर नॉट टेक्नोलॉजिकली वेरी साउंड। ओके, सो दैट इज वन थिंग जो अपने को किधर ना किधर वो लिखना होगा। अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट ये लोग ना इन दिस केस फॉलो अ पुल सिस्टम। पुल सिस्टम के अंदर एवरीथिंग हैज टू बी वेरी कोऑर्डिनेटेड, मटीरियल राइट टाइम पर आना चाहिए सप्लायर लोगों से, सो यू शुड हैव गुड बेस ऑफ सप्लायर्स हु आर रेडी टू सप्लाई यू एज एंड व्हेन रिक्वायर्ड। तो वो वाला चीज भी इस क्वेश्चन के कमेंट्स के अंदर वो आता है। ठीक है, सो यू ऑल गो थ्रू दिस क्वेश्चन, वो 4 पेज का क्वेश्चन है, इट विल नॉट मेक मच सेंस फॉर मी टू ट्राई टू बी रीडिंग इट। सो इन माई सजेस्टेड नो आई हैव गिवन द कंप्लीट सोल्यूशन हाइट हाउ इट इज सपोज टू बी। ओके, सो 4 पेज का आंसर है मेरा, 4 पेज का क्वेश्चन भी था, so I've written that particular answer. उसके अंदर तुम लोगों ने अगर कुछ और वो लिखा वो होगा, you can always try to ask me. Okay, now with that my suggested for SCMPE is all done. Now one thing I have tried to be doing, थोड़ा सा वो जल्दी किया है, only because of one reason, I just wanted कि जिन लोगों ने मे के अंदर एग्जाम वो दिया है उनको मैं बता दूं कि उनको क्या लिखना चाहिए था, ताकि those guys can assess it. That is one thing. Second thing, जिन लोग का नवंबर के अंदर एग्जाम है, टेक द सजेस्टेड फ्रॉम मी, ओके, बट डोंट सी इट, सी द टेक द क्वेश्चन पेपर ऑल्सो फ्रॉम मी बाय राइटिंग ऑन टेलीग्राम आईडी एट द रेट ऑफ एजन एक्स दैट आई टोल्ड यू। ओके, सी द क्वेश्चन पेपर, थिंक ऑफ द आंसर, देन ट्राई टू सी द सजेस्टेड, ओके, ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट, विल बी अ गुड प्रैक्टिस फॉर यू। ओके, एंड जस्ट फॉर द लास्ट टाइम रेफरेंस, ऑल द चैप्टर्स ऑफ SCMPE I have launched almost like, you know, at the rock bottom price at ₹99 only. Spread this to everybody. Just I want that before the old course will expire, everybody in India should be clearing these exams and you should not be stuck because of SCMP. So if you have a difficulty in any chapter only at ₹99, you download my app and you can directly purchase. The things will be starting at that particular time. The notes are also there. You can print those notes also. So there should not be a problem. Okay, SCMP, I'm there till the time SCMP is there, And one announcement also, even under the new course, SEMPE will be there on self-assessment basis. I will take care of that for everybody across the country at the rock bottom price that you all can try. So therefore, I don't want you all to be spending also for that thing much, okay? So if that course will be coming up exactly the way that ICS told, it will be coming from May 24 or November 24. I will take care of that subject. So therefore, that is not a hurdle in you all clearing your CA final, okay? Thank you. Message me on Telegram ID @AJNext, okay? @AJNext. With your name, phone number, and in this case, your attempt, that is November 23 or May 23, and I will hand over this PDF to you. Okay, thank you guys. Bye.